And now, our feature presentation.
Oh. Got a little earlier start this week. I'm up beyond Alberta. I'm probably halfway between Alberta Falls and the lock, and it's just breaking day. I had to
keep my headlamp on for the first
hour on this trip. So it's still a little dark, but really nice. Nice and cool up here. Yeah, I'll check in a while. Okay, I'm starting to warm up, so I had to shed my long sleeve shirt before heading out of here. And we're getting just a hint of orange over the tree line there. Sun's just starting to come up. And I should probably make the lock by the time it's getting nice and light. I just couldn't resist for a little stop here to get a shot of this. The skies with the sun just coming up. It is Saturday, July 12th, and about right close to 5 o'clock. It's a week later and made the lock by 6:20. Got a little earlier start today. Alright, go ahead guys. I'll get a little film of you two. Okay, it's around 7:30 and I have made pretty good time. I'm up here just a little ways shy of Timberline Falls. Got to go over a little bit of ice pack and I'll be up to where I was last week, and then I can try to continue on from that point. When I get up to the stone steps, I'm going to put the crampons on and then see if I can make it on up to Skypond. Not far to go. Okay, I'm up here above Lock Vale. Back at my spot that I was at last Saturday. Top of the stone steps at the ice. And today I have the ice cleats on, or crampons, so I'm going to give it a go on up to Timberline and on up to Skypond from there, so I'll be checking in here shortly. Okay, I've come quite a ways up the ice pack here. Pretty darn steep slope. But the crampons make all the difference. Just got to get across this little section here, and then I think I'm going to take them off. I'm getting out of the spikes. Okay, I've made it up to the timberline. I'm standing right out in front of the fall. Up above the valley this time. Looking down toward the lot. Nice view of the mountains out behind the lot. Yeah, they look a lot bigger when you're up here right under them. Now I have to go around to the right. Climb the rock to get up to Skypond. That's all. That tall wall of ice right here. That's just a big wall of ice down in front of the fall. Up to Skypond. Oh man, I can't believe how heavy my pack feels right now. I'm halfway up Timberline. This is the little rocky trail on up to Skypond. This is where I came from, up through those rocks. This is a little side shoot of the falls. This isn't the main falls, but the, sort of the, looking at the falls, this is on the right hand side. And I'm going to pack it in and get on up to Skypond. Beside Lake of Glass. I'm on the little trail that leads around it and still trekking my way towards Skypond. Don't think I have too much further to go. I'm sort of in a cove here. The wind isn't near as bad as it was right there at the top of the falls. still making my way around Lake of Glass. This is looking up, I believe that is Andrews Glacier that you can see right up over those rocks. Yeah, that's Andrews Glacier. This is a little runoff waterfall from Skypond. That one comes down and feeds into Lake of Glass. And I'm going to cross this field of ice here and go right over those rocks. And I should be right on the other side of these rocks. In front of me should be Skypond. Back down from Skypond, and I'm back at the top of Timberline Falls and getting ready to head down this way to get back on the trail to go over to the lock out there, and then from there head on back down toward Alberta Falls. Starting to get some clouds rolling in. Some of them looking dark. So we could be getting a thunderstorm before too long. I gotta get back down. Well, this is, took a shot here this morning on my way up, and this is a shot coming back down, and the weather has really changed. Clouds are getting dark, and around this way also. I'm glad I'm heading down. It's about 11:30 right now, and I think I'm getting down right at the right time. Get out of here before the thunderstorm rolls in.